I'm in the West Midlands to meet a man called Goldie. Goldie's multi-talented. He's an actor, DJ, and he has an interesting sideline in dentistry. He knows the drill.
Known to his dear old mum as Clifford, Goldie is a true creative innovator. And he's even been a Bond villain. But it all started back in his hometown of Walsall, which is where I'm meeting him now.
Goldie!
We're saying, Paddy, you're right.
How are you?
I'm all right.
Okay, good to see you. You look well.
Let's come back to this old spot.
This is the first house?
This is my old dear's house, 26 North Street.
Still the same?
Still exactly the same.
What I love about yourself and your car history, because I've been looking at it all, I've got a few surprises for you today, is it's so much in common with my car history, the music you used to listen to, everything. So I'm really excited about this. So Luke, without further ado,
right,
let me take you
come
to
on. Let's go have a look.
Let's introduce you.
Itching with a surprise here.
There it is.
Oh, wow.
The old Toyota Corolla.
Is it me? The old Toyota Corolla. Look at that.
Goldie's first ever car was a Toyota Corolla GL. A 75 horsepower 5-speed manual.
Little bits of rust.
Oh, minor.
Get yourself in there. Oh. Get yourself in.
Hang on a second. Hang on.
Oh, look at that. He
How
knows.
How do you like me now?
The old public enemy blurring out.
Public enemy of this, mate, eh?
Look at that. Set her up.
Can I, Paddy?
Here we go. Driving around in a Toyota Corolla with Goldie. Don't get much better than this. You're going to get yours. Here we go.
Oh, steering.
When was the last time you drove a manual?
About 25 years ago.
This will be a real mystery tour. Goldie has no idea where I'm taking him and which of his former vehicles he's going to be reunited with. Right now, we're heading to Wolverhampton, Goldie's old stomping ground when he was a teen.
I'm surprised about how bloody well this car drives.
Lovely drive.
It turns out we're not alone in our love for the Corolla. It's been the world's best-selling car since 1974. There are 40 million of them around the globe. Known locally as Firetown after riots blew up here in the 80s, Goldie's artwork has helped put the area on the world map.
This whole estate was known for graffiti.
What was your, so was your tag Goldie? Was that your, that was your tag, yeah?
Well, you see that? See that top, that window there, the first one?
Yeah.
That was my flat. And next to it,
yeah,
that was the gambling house. So anyone on the estates that wanted to buy weed,
yeah,
play dominoes, or buy chicken, or curry goat, would come there. That's my flat there. People used to walk into my flat and go, had a weed man? I said, no, it's next door, mate. It was pretty much run by all of us, like, really, this estate.
Yeah, yeah.
To be honest. It was a nest, mate. You couldn't, you know, the old Bill had a nightmare.
Yeah.
You know, breakdancing was my thing. And we went from getting girls, going to all-dayers.
Yeah.
And that early scene of that kind of British movement was really huge for us. Mm. And, you know, to see a kid from the local town go to New York and paint and do trains, and it was a big thing for us.
Yeah.
Because for me, it was living the dream.
Yeah. Well, I've got something else for you now, and we'll see what memories this one evokes, and I think you're going to love it. I know you are. Another little surprise for you. Now, which was the best way to get out of here safely?
There's only one way out, Paddy. Run!
Goldie's career would soon take a massive leap forward, meaning he could leave the Corolla behind and get a big boy's car.
Oh, can you see it?
Oh, see look it at that. It? There you've got.
The Cosy. The old Cosy.
Wow.
This is a Mercedes Cosworth 190E, a German super saloon that packs nearly 200 horsepower from a British 2.5-litre Cosworth engine.
Oh, this is the one.
That is the one, mate, that.
Look at that inside, full leather.
2.5, 16 valve, full leather.
Look at the gear stick.
Oh, yeah, dog leg, mate.
That.
Wow.
Shall we take you for a spinette?
Oh, most definitely.
Now, this is a proper car. Here we go. We're out of here.
At 25, this creative maverick moved back from the States and landed in London, where he soon got involved in the jungle music scene. 5 years down the line, Goldie landed a record deal. His pioneering drum and bass album Timeless went to number 7 on the album charts. A groundbreaking moment in the history of dance music.
I just signed the deal, I was the big I am.
Yeah.
Driving around in bloody, you know, in London with a car, massive sound system. For me, it was the ultimate car. And we literally ripped the grill out, lowered it on the front, put the baby grill in, put the chrome rims in from America.
Yeah.
And it was the best
ride. How much did it cost to get the alloys brought?
And the rims were about 10 grand then.
Wow.
The rims were about 10 grand. Probably more than the car was worth.
Wow.
But it was so tricked out because no one had chrome rims. It was new, bringing chromes in. But from living in Miami, the whole kind of gold teeth and car rims, that was the culture there, do you know what I mean?
Goldie's Cosworth was originally designed by Mercedes for touring car championships. It broke a series of speed and endurance records, including one set by the great Ayrton Senna in 1984.
You put this up as one of your top ones you had.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Because I had a black pit bull called Massive that used to sit in the car.
Right.
Whenever I got out of the car, he sat in the front.
As a kind of living alarm.
As a living alarm,
yeah.
But I love this motor. And, you know, I got into this motor today and I thought it reminds me of the first album. You know, and you hear the tunes again and you think about, oh, God, it was all the memories.
Before Goldie gets lost in the 90s, we're going to drive this piece of German engineering wizardry towards Pinewood Studios, where his career took another handbrake turn. Covering over 100 miles in a car renowned for its endurance skills should be a doddle.
Clutch is gone.
No.
I swear to God. The clutch is gone. Clutch!
You know, pretty in gear.
I swear to God, it's gone. I told you the clutch was gone. Oh.
Turn her off, not that anyone's gonna nick it. The heat.
I said to you, didn't I? I said that clutch.
You said that.
It don't smell right.
This of all cars, I thought this would have kept flipping, heck, the heat.
Do us a favour.
Ever the innovator, Goldie comes up with another plan.
Paddy. Hey,
get on the back.
Get on, mate.
Yep, right, hang on, do that. Oh, don't worry, where he's shoeed. I can't believe it.
We're back in the game.